my dog. I'm going to miss him. I hope he's sitting up there looking down high and just, I guess, see us through the times that we do go through. He'd be our angel.
I don't want to think of this as a farewell, but I'll see you later.
I'm gonna miss you, man. Like, for real.
Peter, my name is Brandon Spaulding. I don't want to think of this as a farewell, but I'll see you later. I first met Peter, I want to say, at a party, and I think it was when Unrated was really big in the parties, Super Goose and stuff. I think something happened, and all I know. He was down for the crew. So instantly, he was fine.
When we're playing Call of Duty, Ghost, you got my back, bro. Feel me? I'm talking about, I want all insta-kills. I want all miniguns, max ammo, all that. But now I'm playing them. But for real, though, man, we're going to miss you. RIP, man, and see you when we get there.
You've just been there. Like, he been a part of the family. Like, it's just... I don't know. Like, it's a lot of stuff that I wish I could say or whatever, but right now I really just can't put anything into the right words. You are a brother, friend, homeboy, business partner, all of that, man.
Last remarks. I'll see you later, bro.
He was messing with their girl. I mean, we all know Peter was a player, you know. So, you know, when he tried to fight him, I was there, I had his back, you know. So, ever since then, we've been bros. And that was like years ago. Peter done let me come stay with this man when I had no place to go. When I needed money or I needed food or something, he was there. So, you know, he there for me, I was there for him, you know. And it's kind of sad, you know, see him go, but at the same time, it's a good thing because at least we know he's in a better place. You know, he ain't struggling, he ain't sad, you know, he ain't going through nothing bad, you know what I'm saying? And he looking out all of us, you know what I'm saying? Watching over all of us. So, you know, I just pray everything good for this family. You know, I'm praying for Porsche, I'm praying for everybody. But PD, we miss you, we're gonna miss you. Always gonna be family, always gonna be my bruh. I'm always be there for you, always be there for me.
Armand Knowles, a part of Unrated, and basically, I met Peter through Jerry, and we were just talking about making a song together, and when that was my first time going to his house, and went to his house, got to know him personally when we were making songs and stuff, didn't get to finish it, unfortunately, A1 since day one. song. Yeah, that was real cool. But after that, I found out I was in the house. Saw he played Call of Duty. So you see me, I play Call of Duty all the time. So later on in the months, you know, I wasn't in touch with him as much as I could, as I wanted to. So when I found out he played online and stuff, I said, hey man, contact me. We just ended up video Xbox brothers, basically. That was the only time I was able to talk to him, was when he got off work, played online. And one thing about it, this man would stay online all night. That man would never quit playing the video game. I had to quit because that man would stay up so late. But I really had love for him. You know, he was real cool. And I'm gonna miss him, truthfully. And I'm gonna pray for your family. And really loved him, so yeah.
Hey y'all, my name is Bach. Me and Peter went pretty far back from the moment he came to Savannah. Brandon, his brother, told me to watch over him, you know what I'm saying? So like I did my best. We had a killing year at Savannah State. But yeah, he was a good dude. Like no matter what things was going on or what everybody was going through, he was always a good dude, man. Don't find a lot of those these days. You know? Yeah, man. Farewell, bro.
He made his dream become a reality, actually making it possible to swim. Way up out of Compton with furthermore to accomplish. Graduate with honors, a sponsor of basketball scholars. It's 2004 and I'm watching them score 30. Remember vividly how them victory points had hurt me, cause every basket was a reaction or a reminder that we was just moving backwards. The bungalow where you find us, the art of us ditching classes, headed nowhere fast. Stick my head inside the study hall, he focused on math. Determination, ambition, plus dedication and wisdom. Qualities he was given was the shit we didn't have. Dug inside of his book bag when Coach Palmer asked for his finals. He had his back like a spinal. Meanwhile, we singing the same old song, spinning the vinyl. 11 graders gone wrong. He focused on the NBA, we focused on some Patron. Now watch that black boy fly. I used to be jealous of J.C. Young. I used to be jealous of J.C. Young. Taylor when I was young. Taylor made a career out of music from writing songs. A Buick had driven past, bumping him when I mowed the lawn. Money laundering, hustling, homies pondering up against schemes to make a million, even if doing you harm. What's the case? And just in case she wasn't alarmed, the city had fought with firearms and many had died before dawn. It's 2004 and I'm hearing the people roar. For the name of the game, they line in front of the store. Swap me, selling out mixtapes. I'm like, oh shit, wait. Don't wanna be another nigga stuck regretting mistakes. Mixed feelings was my opinion. I was defending my insecurities, chilling my conscience next to a villain. Compton made you believe success wasn't real. Be honest, none of us knew of a record deal. So as I peel through these lottery tickets, I see a Harley Davidson truck visit the same plaza we shop. A tall nigga hopped out with Jordans and a white tank top. He was top of the rap game, he was the top of the block. So watch that black boy fly.
Black boy fly, watch that black boy fly. Black boy fly, watch that black boy fly. Black boy fly, watch that black boy fly. Black boy.
My mama didn't raise me up to be jealous hearted like most of the winners call it. Regardless of where you stay, hold your head and continue marching. That's what she said, but in my head I wanted to be like Jordan. A war touring the country with money from mic recording. The only way out the ghetto, you know the stereotype. Shooting hoops, I live on the stereo like top 40. And shortly I got discouraged, like every time I walk to the corner and them guns bursting. Nigga, I was rehearsing in repetition the phrase that only one in a million will ever see better days, especially when the crime wave.